Kreg Llewellyn is one of Canada's most successful skiers of all time. His respect for the overall crown ran deep because he always wanted to be the ultimate warrior. Kreg was an innovator in all aspects, but because of his raw athletic ability, the trick event would never be the same. Kreg was willing to try anything. Reinventing was a daily routine. He remodeled the stepovers and was the first to perform what we now know as body overs. He helped design and test the first ever skurfer, which was a precursor to the evolution of wakeboarding. He won the first ever World Wakeboard Championship in Hawaii. At the 1991 Worlds, he was a mere decimal two short of the overall crown, but his two individual event medals helped Canada top the undefeated U.S. team for the first time. Congratulations, Kreg Llewellyn.
Canadian Kreg Llewellyn, the older brother of Jarrett. Kreg made his debut in the 85 World Championships by placing fifth in this event.
And he's also a strong overall contender. And one of the keys to overall is the mastery of this event, which Kreg has done. He's so close to the world standards that he can mount up overall points over other competitors.
And on the water right now for his first pass, Kreg Llewellyn.
He's getting settled in, and he's signaling to the boat, the boat speed. That's very critical, and it's optional depending on what you like, what's your preference. Probably about 17 miles per hour right now during the tow pass. I'm sure he's not satisfied with the semifinal round, and this is no time to hold back. He's really got to cut loose here and be aggressive because this is the last round of competition. Some tow stepovers right there. Moves into tow step over five, one of the neatest maneuvers you'll see out on the water. And another step over 360, and he falls towards the end, completing most of his tricks, but I know he would have liked to have gotten that one.
Hey, this is a tough event. And earlier, Wayne, I know you talked to him about what makes the Masters so tough.
I think it's the competition. The competition's always gears and tries to peak for this tournament. And so everybody seems to ski their best here, and everybody knows that. So that really tends to psych out a lot of people. And if you're not prepared, you're going to get beat here.
Older brother Kreg Llewellyn will now try to attack the ramp. And I do mean try. This has been a test all day long.
And that is a slick performance right there. Smooth through the wake, skis together. Wonderful opening leap.
185 feet for Kreg Llewellyn.
Sits back a little bit, kind of a resisting spring, but not a bad lift, combined with good speed to the base of the jump.
Well, this is brother Kreg Llewellyn, the older brother, 24 years old, currently ranked second overall in the world. His personal best is 5 at a 37-foot tow line.
And he'll be starting on a 39-foot tow line. Again, I will remind you that you have 1 foot left over at the ball because it's 38 feet from the center of the boat course to the turning ball.
The boat is considerably faster in the men's competition. It's 36 miles per hour.
And that's just 16 seconds for the boat to go from one end of the course to the other, which is fast. Kreg is a left foot forward skier and he uses a double boot. Skiers can choose a double boot or just a front boot and a kick in at the back. And there is no agreement as to which is the most advantageous.
No problems for Kreg Llewellyn in pass number four. He completes a perfect six pass again. We'll remind you, his personal best is 5 at 37-foot tow line.
And there's that key number one turn. And you can see on the 39-foot tow line, he is skiing very strongly.
Kreg Llewellyn has come from behind. He is indeed the Masters Tricks champion. Just an unbelievable finish. Kreg Llewellyn giving high fives all the way around. Why not?
Such a fine line from being on top of the water and in the water in the trick skiing event.
Let's go to the final standings then. And there you have it. Kreg Llewellyn wins by a mere 90 points over second place Tori Baggiano. Patrice Martin winds up in third. Let's go down to the water now. And Wayne has our winner.
Your trick skiing has always been your specialty. After you fell in the second pass, I guess you had serious doubts about where you'd place.
Definitely. It's, you know, everybody tries to put their best run in the finals, but then again, the pressure is really tough at the Masters, and especially in the final round, and everybody knows that they have to go all out, and so that's probably what happened.
You know, trick skiers, rhythm is so much to the game. I gather you are out on the water first. You're out on the water first, and you just had to put the throttle down.
That's exactly right. I just had to think. I was just thinking about exactly what I need to do and focus on some key things I had to do to finish the run, and it worked out.
Well, congratulations. First victory at the Masters. Very sweet.
It's great. Thanks a lot.
So far, Kreg, it's a 1-2 Llewellyn punch. You went 185. Younger brother goes 186.
Yeah, it should be the other way around. But it's rough out there, and anybody, it's just survival out there and just trying to hope for the best conditions in front of the jump, because that's where it seems like it's the worst.
This is that moment of decision where he decides to cut back to the ramp. He's getting a lot of speed here. It's a good spring at the end, and look at, he's past the towboat. That's a long jump.
Wow, great jump for Kreg Llewellyn. 190 feet, 57.9 meters. That's a new Shalom Park record.
And this is how he did it. A lot of speed at the bottom of the ramp and a good spring. And a nice flight, a little hang in the air there, and he digs his knees up to try and lengthen it, and he gets 190 feet.
You can probably talk to about every overall skier that has done it in the past, Sammy Duvall, Carl LaBerge. You ask them what's the most memorable win that they've ever had, and I guarantee they'll end up saying that the overall win was the most gratifying. To win an overall title is unbelievable, and takes so much more dedication and a lot more drive, and to get all those events to work together on that one day is a real challenge.
Take it in, but don't look down. 'Cause I'm on top of the world.